Hello, aspiring coders! It's B here again, ready to take you on another exciting adventure in the world of computer programming. In today's lesson, we're going to explore the concept of computing aggregate values. Think of these as special tools that help us summarize or find out important information about a list of numbers or items. Specifically, we'll focus on calculating the sum and discovering the minimum and maximum values in a list. We'll also learn how to check if a list contains a specific item. These techniques are incredibly useful for analyzing and understanding data, just like how astronomers analyze stars to understand the galaxy. The ability to swiftly compute totals, identify extreme values, and verify specific elements in a data set plays a critical role in various fields, especially in space exploration. Taking a list of values and applying a calculation to them that results in one value is called computing aggregate values. For instance, when planning a lengthy space mission, calculating the total sum of resources like fuel and food supplies becomes indispensable. This sum gives us a clear picture of how long the spacecraft can sustain its crew and operations, ensuring the mission's feasibility and safety. Here's an example of calculating the sum of elements in an array. We have an array of integers named water containers, where each element represents the gallons of water in a container. We initialize a variable total water to 0. This variable will keep track of the total amount of water as we add the contents of each container. We then use a for loop to iterate over each element named water container in the water containers array. For each iteration, the variable water container holds the amount of water in the current container. We add water to total water during each iteration, accumulating the total amount of water. Finally, we print out total water, which now contains the sum of all the gallons of water in the containers. How do you think you might use a count variable to determine the average amount of water in the containers if we have the total in total water? Try this in your guided notes. We will start with the same code we had before. This time, we will introduce another variable to count how many containers we have. Let's call it count and set it to 0. Next, when our loop is over, we will divide the total water by the count variable to get the average. Now, let's move on to finding the minimum and maximum values. We have a few planets that we have been monitoring, and we have stored their average temperature data in an array called temperatures. We now want to look through this array and find both the lowest, or the minimum, as well as the highest, or the maximum, temperature. Now, if we had access to this list, we could find the smallest number or largest number pretty easily. However, if we didn't have direct access to the list, or the amount of numbers in the list was very large, it would be very helpful to have a computer do this for us. We will split these calculations into two separate programs. One to find the highest temperature, and one to find the lowest temperature. First, let's find the highest temperature from our list of recorded temperatures. To do that, we need to start somewhere, so we initialize a variable called max temperature to a temperature that is very low. We use negative 1000 to represent a temperature that's lower than any real temperature we could have in the list. It's like saying, let's start with a temperature that's colder than any possible temperature. Now we use a for loop to go through each temperature in the list one by one. The loop starts here, for temp in temperatures. It's like looking at each temperature measurement, starting with the first one. Inside the loop, we compare the current temperature, temp, with our assumed highest temperature, max temperature. We ask, is the current temperature, temp, higher than our assumed highest max temperature? If the current temperature, temp, is indeed higher than our assumed highest max temperature, then we update max temperature to be equal to the current temperature. It's like saying, oh, this temperature is higher than we thought was the highest, so let's consider this one as the new highest. The loop continues, and we repeat this process for each temperature in the list. We keep comparing and updating max temperature as needed. For example, if our temperatures are 68, 23, and 100, the computer would start by looking at the first temperature, 68. Is that greater than negative 1000? Yes, so 68 is our max temperature right now. Next, is 23 greater than 68? No, so we move on. Is 100 greater than 68? Yes, so 100 is our max temperature right now. Since we are done with our list and max temperature is currently 100, we can be sure that max temperature now holds the highest temperature among all the measurements. Finally, we print out the highest temperature we found. Print highest temperature, max temperature. Let's summarize our algorithm for finding the highest value within an array. This code goes through a list of temperatures, starts with an initial assumption of a very low temperature for max temperature. And as it checks each temperature in the list, it updates max temperature if it finds a temperature higher than the current assumption. At the end, it tells us what the highest temperature is. Next, let's find the lowest temperature. What changes do you think we would make in the original program in order to display this? Here's a hint. Instead of initializing max temperature to a really small number like negative 1000, we should now use a large number like 1000. Give it a try in your guided notes. Instead of initializing max temperature to a very low value, we now use a very high value and assign it to min temperature. We now check if the current temperature, temp, is lower than our assumed lowest temperature, min temperature. We now update min temperature instead of max temperature. Finally, when printing, we should print the min temperature variable. As we prepare to replant the plants collected from our last mission, we need to determine the total number of plants we have. Each element in the array, plants per species, represents the count of plants for a specific species. To calculate the total number of plants, you'll need to iterate through each element in the array using a for loop. Once you have calculated the total number of plants, please call the function fetch pots sum and pass the total as an argument. This function will help me determine the number of flower pots we need for replanting. Your contribution will greatly assist us in efficiently organizing the replanting process. Today's journey taught us how to determine an aggregate value, which is a single value calculated from a list of values. For example, we were able to calculate sums, find the average value, and find minimum and maximum values. We've equipped ourselves with essential skills for exploring and interpreting data through programming. Be sure to complete the programming tasks, practice questions, and extension activities before moving on to the next lesson. And remember, in the universe of coding, the possibilities are infinite. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.